I'm sick and tired of corporate America not paying their fair share. We can pay for these things. I'm not talking about deficit spending. The point is, what I'm proposing is badly needed and able to be paid for and still grow.
Welcome back. 13 minutes after the hour now, President Biden pitching his American jobs plan in Louisiana as part of a nationwide blitz to sell his sweeping $1 trillion spending proposal. But does it really give the working class a leg up? Turning Point USA contributor and 11-year Army veteran Graham Allen joins us now to discuss. Graham, it's always great to see you. Why do you say Joe Biden is killing the American dream?
Well, the biggest thing, I heard the clip just a minute ago, you know, we've got the ability to pay for these things. We're going to pay for it. We're going to pay for it. Yeah, those are called taxes, and America is going to have to pay those taxes. Is it $400,000 a year? Is it $200,000 a year? No one really knows. Joe Biden is killing the American dream because of this. Right here in South Carolina, we have a workforce shortage right now. Our governor, Henry McMaster's, just put into place that South Carolina will no longer be accepting any federal-related pandemic relief money, because what it's doing is incentivizing people to want to stay home as opposed to go outside and work, all right? The American dream is alive and well, but the American dream looks a lot like opportunity, and opportunity looks a lot like hard work. We have an administration with a vice president that says that nobody should have to work two jobs to be able to make their dreams come true. Well, who says that? Where is that written in the Constitution that you're not going to have to work hard, very hard, to make your dreams happen? I hate the fact that people have to pay for child care. Trust me, I've done it. I have three children myself. I was a E4 in the military during the time. I understand what it's like to have to put baby formula and diapers on a credit card just to be able to pay, to be able to take care of your children, to make things go. But what we can't do is act like money just grows on trees.
Right.
The American people need to realize you will be paying for these things that they do. This is where the government gets their money, tax credits, free health care, or excuse me, not free health care, free child care, free community college for 2 years, expanding unemployment benefits, et cetera. These are all things that are going to be paid for
exactly through
taxes.
Hey, Graham, I want to pop up. I want to pop up on the screen the price tag before we're running out of time here. You can see it's upwards of $5.7 trillion overall.
Insane.
As somebody who understands what it takes to motivate people, to lead people with your Army experience, what happens when people stop striving for greatness? About 45 seconds on the back end.
I think that the idea of exceptionalism in America is what makes us Americans. The idea that we innately cherish more what we work for as opposed to what we're given. It is impossible for us to love America, love what we have, if it's given to us versus us working hard for those things. We need people to, we don't need a stimulus check. We don't need another stimulus payment. We don't need more federal spending. We need jobs, and we need people to get up and go to work.
It's incumbent upon us as individuals, it seems, to maintain that American dream in our own lives, with our own families, and in our own communities. Otherwise, like you said, could be going the way of the dodo. Graham
Absolutely.
Allen, as always,
Absolutely.
A pleasure. We appreciate it. Jillian.